Happy Halloween, everybody! Unless you're not watching this on Halloween, in which case, Merry Christmas? I don't know. So at the time I'm recording this, Inktober 2021 is coming to a close. And this year I fell a bit behind on my Inktober drawings because for the last couple of weeks I've been busy working on other things. Anyway, nevertheless, I still wanted to participate in Inktober this year, so I decided to spend the last couple of days of the month cranking out these drawings. And I also decided to do a little sketchbook tour so you can see my art. That's right, we're doing this again! Cause for some reason, a lot of people seem to like my last Inktober video. But for anyone who hasn't seen it, it's one of my earlier videos, so please don't watch it. Anyway, with that said, let's hop into this video! Okay, so day one, the theme was crystal, and what I wanted to do this year was that for every single one of my drawings, I would have a girl in them, and I would have that girl kind of have a clown-like look to her, like a lot of makeup and very colorful clothes, sort of, something along those lines. I don't know if that really came out very well in the end, but, you know, that's what I was going for. So for the first drawing, I had a girl wearing crystal necklaces and earrings and basically just crystal jewelry. So that's what I went with for day one. Okay, so for day two, the theme was suit, so I tried to have a bit of a darker look to it. I know I literally just said that I wanted all of my characters to be very bright and colorful, but since suits are very kind of gray and dark, I had my character look kind of silly, but also kind of serious in that sort of way. So for day three, the theme was vessel, and for some reason when I heard that, the first thing that popped into mind was a pregnant lady, so I kind of just drew a pregnant clown-like woman, again fitting with my theme that I made for myself. So for day four, the theme was knot, and I decided that I wanted to do it where a girl has a knot in her hair. I realized that in the end it kind of ended up looking like she had a bun in her hair, but it didn't come out exactly the way I wanted, but I feel like it came out pretty good, so that's kind of what I went with. So for day five, the theme was Raven, and I'm a really big Teen Titans fan and I love superheroes, so I decided to draw the character Raven instead of the bird, which I honestly think came out pretty good. This is probably one of my favorite ones I did for all of Inktober, so that's cool. Okay, so for day six, the theme was spirit, and when I heard this one, I instantly thought about the Will of the Wisps from Brave, and how they were guiding Merida to the witch's house, so I ended up just drawing one of them next to Merida, and Merida ended up looking really weird, in my opinion. I don't really like the way that she came out, but yeah, it's fine. I did my best. So for day seven, the theme was fan, and I am a really big Batman fan. Like, he's my favorite superhero of all time. So I ended up just drawing a girl who is a really big Batman fan. I tried to give her Batman earrings, which I honestly think came out kind of weird looking, but I don't know. I don't know if that really came across, but whatever, so this is probably one of my least favorite ones. I hate the way it came out, because it doesn't really look very fan-like. It kind of just is a girl wearing a t-shirt, so I don't know, but whatever, I tried. So for day eight, the theme was watch, and I decided that what I wanted to do was I'd have a girl looking at her watch because she's late for something, hence the dialogue I put here. And when I finished it, I liked the way that it looks, but I feel like it's kind of hard to tell that she's looking at a watch, because the watch is kind of hard to see. I don't know. I feel like it could have been better, but whatever. That was my bad. So for day nine, the theme was pressure, and what I originally wanted to do was I wanted to have it where this girl is under a lot of fabric and lace, kind of like in her dress, and that would be the pressure. But then I also sort of thought when I finished it, oh, this looks really good, but I have this whole empty space up here. What if I put something like dialogue? And then I thought, oh, what if it's society's pressure to make women look pretty? So I put be pretty, because I'm trying to be very deep. Honestly, this is my favorite one that I did, and I'm really proud of it, and I honestly love the way it came out, so, you know. Yay me. Okay, so for day 10, the theme was pick, and I for some reason went immediately to that scene in Emperor's New Groove where Cusco has to pick his bride and they're all lined up and look exactly the same except their hair is a bit different. So I ended up just kind of doing that, and it kind of ended up looking really bad. I don't really like the way it looks, and I feel like it definitely doesn't work for me. I don't know. I mean, maybe someone out there likes it, but it doesn't work for me. I feel like I messed it up, and honestly, it could have been better, so forget this one. So for day 11, the theme was sour, so I decided that I would try drawing Harley Quinn eating a lollipop, but the lollipop was sour. And only after I finished drawing it did I realize that lollipops are not sour, they're sweet. And then I kind of just slapped myself in the face because I realized that I just wasted an entire hour drawing this thing. And lollipops aren't even sour. I mean, maybe some are, but yeah, it kind of was a failure on my part, but whatever. I honestly really like this one. I like the way it came out, and I really like the way I did my lollipop, so it wasn't a total disaster, but, you know, I didn't realize that. It didn't occur to me that maybe that's stupid until I finished it, so whatever. So for day 12, the theme was stuck, and I kind of wanted to do it where some girl is stuck in a dress, because for some reason, anytime that I ever wear a dress, the zipper always gets stuck, so I thought that that would be kind of funny. But after I finished doing it, you can't really see that she's trying to unzipper the dress, which I realized when I finished drawing the picture. So I was kind of like, well, that sucks, because you can't really tell. I mean, you could probably infer it, but it's not very clear, so I was kind of disappointed by the end product, but ultimately I think that it came out okay. So for day 13, the theme was roof, and I decided that I would just have someone sitting on a roof looking up at the stars, and I honestly really liked this one. I think it came out really good, and yeah, I think the coloring and shading was much better than in most of my other pictures, because I was trying to add a lot more shadows, because it's nighttime, and I wanted to make sure that you could tell that there's only one light source. Except, in the middle of drawing Inktober, doing all these Inktober drawings, I realized that my pens were all running out of ink, so I wasn't able to do this as darkly shaded as I wanted. And, you know, here on out, most of my drawings, the ink is gonna start to become a little less good. To say the least, it's definitely not going to look the best here on out. Okay, so for day 14, the theme was tick, so I just had someone sitting and looking at a ticking clock, and this is honestly the worst one I did. I barely put any effort into it. I kind of got bored while drawing it, so I kind of gave up halfway through. That's why it isn't one of my better ones. So, yeah. This one is not one of my best. Let's move on. Okay, so for day 15, the theme was helmet, so I decided to draw a girl wearing a helmet. I kind of think that she's like a baseball player, but I don't know, some sort of athlete or something. I don't really know what she's supposed to be, but I tried to make the helmet purple so you could clearly tell that, you know, it stands out more and everything else is a bit redder. I don't know, I just thought that it would help it pop. And I like this one. I think it came out pretty good. Okay, so day 16, the theme was compass, and instantly I thought about Linkle from, you know, the Legend of Zelda sort of games. And, you know, she has a compass around her neck, so I tried drawing her, and honestly, I love the way this one came out, and it's one of my favorites. The only thing that I don't like about it is that I didn't proportion it right, and I kind of messed it up, so the compass is a bit cut off. But other than that, I think it came out pretty good, so yeah, besides for the fact that the theme is halfway not in frame, but that's fine. I still really like it. Okay, so for day 17, the theme was collide, and since I've been hit with tennis balls more times than I would like to admit in my lifetime, I instantly thought about a ball colliding into someone's head, so I ended up just drawing that, and yeah, I used to play tennis when I was in high school, so I know all about getting hit in the head with tennis balls, or accidentally hitting someone else in the head with a tennis ball. So, yeah, this one is very true to home for me. Okay, so for day 18, the theme was moon, and what I wanted to do is have the reflection of the moon in someone's glasses. So, yeah, I honestly really like this one. I think it came out pretty good. The only problem I have with it is that I wanted this to be a bit more blue than purple, except all of my blue pens started running out of ink in the middle of drawing this, so I ended up having to use a lot of purple for the shading, which I think came out pretty good. But yeah, I definitely think it would have looked better if it was a bit bluer. Also, the moon is a bit hard to see in the reflection, which kind of annoyed me. I tried my very best to get it to be a bit more visible, but it kind of just looks like she has really weird eyes. I don't know. But I tried, and I like this one, all things considered, and yeah, I'm pretty proud of this one. I really like the way that the shading and the coloring came out, so yeah. All things considered, it's not bad. It could be better. But whatever. Okay, so for day 19, the theme was loop. And I kind of cheated on this one because I couldn't think of a good hairstyle, because what I wanted to do was braid loops, kind of like the ones that I have here. And I decided that I was going to use a reference image for this one, and that's kind of just what I did. I found a picture of a girl, and I just copied that. I know it's cheating, but all things considered, I honestly couldn't think of anything, because I normally do not do my hair in braids ever, because I can't braid my hair, so I had to cheat. I guess it's for the greater good, because this one's one of my favorites, and I really like it, so, you know. I know I keep saying that, but they are my favorites. Okay, so this one is Sprout for day 20, and I hate this one. I hate this face. Look at this. It looks terrible. What even is this? Why is the nose all the way up here? I honestly hate it so much. The sprouts, you can't even see them. The coloring is awful. I'm very disappointed in myself. I hate it, but whatever. The whole thing for this one is that this girl's holding a plant full of sprouting buds, which look terrible. I mean, look at this. Terrible. Shameful. But whatever. So for day 21, the theme was fuzzy, so I instantly thought about a fuzzy sweater. If you've seen The Nanny, which is one of my favorite shows of all time, there's one episode where Fran is wearing a really fuzzy orange sweater, and I instantly thought of that, so I just kind of replicated the sweater to the best of my abilities from memory, and I really like this one. I think it came out really cute, and I honestly love it. I wish I had a sweater like this. Okay, so for day 22, the theme was open, and I kind of thought about what if someone's head opened and you could see inside their mind. So that's sort of what I tried to do, where it was like this very colorful and bright exterior, but also a very dark and demon-like interior, like your insides are so dark and evil. I don't know, I just thought it would look cool. I tried to be very bright and colorful with it and have a lot of flashy colors so contrast with the interior. I honestly couldn't think of anything to do for the inside, so I just did a demon eye. I didn't plan this out very well, but I really like it. I also tried to give her rainbows in her eyes, and I love the way that looks. I think it's very cool. So yeah, this one is very sparkly too. I just wanted to really go all out with it. So this one is one of my better ones, I think. It's not one of my favorites, but I think that it came out the best out of all of them. Okay, so for day 23, the theme was leaks, so what I did was drew a girl crying. Her eyes are leaking. That's all I could really come up with, honestly. I know, it's not terribly creative, but whatever. You may notice that the tears are very blue. That's because when I was drawing this, all of my blue pens were running out of ink, and the only color I had that wasn't completely dead was a very dark shade of blue. And I know that tears aren't actually that color of blue, but that was all I had to work with, so whatever. But yeah, I really was running out of colors by this point. So you're gonna notice a lot of things are very green from here on out, because green was one of the only colors I had that wasn't completely dead. So for day 24, the theme was extinct. So I, for some reason, even though I'm not really a huge Star Wars fan, thought about how at one point in the movies, the Jedi went extinct. So I just drew a Jedi soldier. I was trying to come up with an original Jedi look, but I honestly think that it just looks weird. I was trying to make an alien that has kind of reddish skin, but again, all of my colors were running out of ink, so she kind of looks a bit pinker and not very Jedi-like. I tried to match the robes that they wear. I don't know. It came out pretty bad, but whatever. I also would have liked to make the lightsaber blue, but I didn't have any blue, so I had to go with green. Okay, so for day 25, the theme was splat, so naturally I decided to go with blood splatter. I honestly don't draw a lot of stuff with blood or people covered in blood, so I realized that this doesn't look great, but honestly, I like the way it came out. I think that the shading came out very nice. I had just enough blue ink in my pens left, so that way I could do this dark blue outline from the light, and yeah, I think that it came out pretty good. All things considered though, after I finished it, I took a look at it and I realized that this kind of looks like Carrie. I don't know if you see that too, but whatever. That wasn't what I was going for, but it's kind of how it ended up looking. So whatever. Okay, so for day 26, the theme was connect, and naturally I thought about, oh, friendship, connection. And then they have like a little best friend's locket, which I used to have when I was younger with my friends. And basically, you know, it's like connecting it. And yeah, I tried to have the colors be different so they match. So this girl has kind of pinkish hair, so her friend has a pink locket side, and she has kind of purple hair, so she has a kind of purplish side. I don't know. I'm not the best with color theory. I did my best with what I had. After I finished it, I did kind of realize that this kind of looks like Starfire and Raven from Teen Titans, which is not what I was going for, but it's kind of how it ended up looking. But it's fine. It's okay. So for day 27, the theme was spark, so I kind of thought, oh, like a spark of creativity coming up with like an idea. So I just kind of had a thought bubble with a bunch of electricity in it, except when I was drawing this, the colors were kind of hard to see and you couldn't really tell it was a lightning bolt, so I just tried adding a lot of orange and yellow, which ultimately made it look so much worse. So now it just kind of looks like some crazy thing hovering over this girl's head, and she's very happy about it. She doesn't seem to mind, which is not what I was going for when I drew this, but it's just kind of how it ended up looking in the end. So yeah, this isn't one of my better ones, but whatever, it's fine. So day 28, the theme was crispy, so I went with bacon and someone eating bacon. And yeah, I hate the way the hands came out in this drawing, especially this hand, and the bacon didn't really look very bacony. I honestly, it's a failure. It's okay, but this hand is too small, this hand is too weird looking, and the bacon doesn't look anything like actual bacon, so not one of my favorites, but you know, maybe someone likes it. I'm very critical of my art. I can't see any good in this if I can't enjoy the way the bacon looks. So for day 29, the theme was patch, and when I read patch, I kind of thought of Patchy the Pirate from SpongeBob, and then I kind of thought, oh, why don't I draw a pirate with an eye patch? And yeah, that's what I ended up doing. There's not really much to say about this one. I think it came out pretty good. It's just a pirate with an eye patch, so yeah, pretty simple, but I like it. So for day 30, the theme was Slither, and instantly after reading that, my mind immediately went to, oh, Slytherin from Harry Potter! So I just ended up drawing a Slytherin girl. And I also tried to have her carrying a Slytherin flag here, and I wrote Slytherin in it, but I didn't measure it out very well. I didn't measure it out at all. And it ended up just kind of getting cut off. I tried my very best to make it look good, but you can't really read it very well. I don't know, maybe you can, but to me it just didn't come out great. But, you know, I think that other than that, it came out looking pretty decent. So, yeah. I'm Slytherin House, by the way. And so, for the last one, for day 31, the theme was Risk, and honestly, I couldn't think of anything very good to draw. I just kind of thought, oh, what if I draw a girl in a crazy outfit and then have her saying, time to hit that job interview, because that would be risky, dressing like that to a job interview. I was originally going to have someone walking on a tightrope, but then I changed it. So, yeah. This is kind of the last one, so I kind of rushed it. It's not really one of my better ones, because I was like, ugh, I just want this to be over since I tried to do all of this in one sitting, like an idiot. And those are my Inktober 2021 drawings. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly liked my drawings a lot better than I did from last year. Of course, drawing all this stuff in one sitting was kind of a pain on my hands. So if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go ice my fingers now. Happy Halloween!